The biggest misnomer about the Weeknd has nothing to do with the spelling of his name. Any millennial worth their avocado toast knows to leave out the E, or one of his most mainstream hits, Nope, Can't Feel My Face isn't about a talk. Rather, it's about the Canadian singer-songwriter behind the commanding stage presence, genre blending sound and drug-laced lyric. People always say when they meet me that I'm not what they expect, he admitted to Vanity Fair back in 2015, when people still saw the edgy part-R&B, part-pop artist as a somewhat mysterious recluse, a holdover from his days of deliberately obscuring. I assume they think I'm the super dark and depressing guy, but I like to channel all of those emotions into my work. I'm pretty laid back in real life. I just love hanging with my friends and making the jokes don't stop, literally, all day. It was his public persona, however, that inspired his latest effort. March's After Hours, his first disc since 2016's Starboy, earned him 2 MTV Video Music Awards, from 6 nominations, an American Music Award and a spot on virtually every Best of 2020 listed. And yet he came up empty when Grammy nominations were announced, a snub that did not go unnoticed by his contemporary. Thankfully the Super Bowl halftime show, and a Pepsi ad featuring his Impossibly catch blinding lights, is quite the consolation. We all grow up watching the world's biggest acts playing the Super Bowl and one can only dream of being in that position, he shared. I'm humbled, honored and ecstatic to be the center of that infamous stage this year. Sure to get a lot of play, his critically acclaimed disc about the darkest time of my entire life, around 2013, 2014, as he put it to Variety. I was getting really tossed up and going through a lot of personal stuff. I got arrested in Vegas. Revisiting his real rock star era wasn't the easiest, he continued. I didn't want to. But sometimes you try to run away from who you are, and you always get back to that. By the end of this album, you realize, I'm not that person. I was, but I'm growing and wiser, and I'm gonna have children someday, and I'm going to tell them they don't have to be. How's that for private? While the Weeknd's interviews are rare, his candor is plentiful as he speaks on the loneliness of his Toronto childhood, the drug-induced haze of his teens and his recipe. And in honor of his birthday, we've dug up 30 tidbits about the motherf kin Starboy. You know you love it. You love it. Trending stories 1. Johnny Galecki calls out ex Kaley Cuoco's anniversary note to husband 2. Kendall Jenner makes romance with Devin Booker official. Shailene Woodley and Aaron Rodgers celebrate Valentine's Day in Montreal. Originally published February 16, 2023 AM PT.